Hello students, in last lecture we have seen what is World Wide Web, then client server architecture. Today we will start with network and internet. So what is network? The network is two or more connected computers which can share resources like printer, plotter, a file server and internet connection or application. It is a collection of computer systems and devices which are linked together using a wireless network or via communication devices and transmission media. So, in network, there are different types of computers which are connected to each other. Next, what is internet? The internet is a massive network of networks. A networking infrastructure. It connects millions of computers together globally, forming a network in which any computer can communicate with any other computer as long as they are both connected to the internet. Information that travels over the internet does so via a variety of languages known as protocol. The internet is a worldwide network of computers that gives customers access to information and documents from distant sources. Internet has the capability to transform society. With the appearance of the internet, distance is not that big an obstacle for commerce. Internet is the most important communication media to have come along in the last few decades, and businesses have to make wise use of this medium. The value of internet lies in the connection it enables. There are three types of networks which are very important, can be created on the internet. These types of networks can be created on the internet. The first type of network is the one-to-many, okay? One-to-many or broadcast network in which a supplier provides information to a large number of users. For example, a website delivers news to a large number of users. Next, the second type of network is the one-to-one or transactional network in which one individual connects with other individuals to exchange information or complete the transaction. Example for this one-to-one network, an individual can send emails to his friend or colleague. Okay, this is the example for one-to-one network. The third type of network is the many-to-many or group-forming network in which members form and maintain communicating groups. Examples of this many-to-many group forming networks are online communities and business-to-business exchanges. Okay, this is the example for third network, that is many-to-many. So in broadcast network, the value of the network increases as the number of users increases, but the value increases only linearly. That is, every new member adds the same amount of value. Okay. So, next we will see communication switching. Communication switching. Through the use of communication switching, computer networks allow computers to transfer data using shared lines of communication such as cables. Communication switching works similar to telephone switching network. A telephone switching network eliminates the need to connect a wire between your telephone and every telephone you may ever call instead. The phone company connects your phone to a set of phones. Okay, this is the telephone switching network. In circuit switch network, the connection provides for transmission at a constant data rate. Okay, there are in packet switching that are transmitting in short packets. Next is circuit switching. What is circuit switching? In a circuit switching, the switches create a single unbroken path between devices that want to communicate. In circuit switch network, the connection provides for transmission at a constant data rate. Thus, each of the two devices that are connected must transmit and receive at the same data rate as the other. This limits the utility of the network in interconnecting host computers and terminals. Next, we will see the packet switching. Okay. In packet switching, programs break data into small pieces called as packets and then transmit the packet between different computers. Packets are pieces of data that stay attached to a standard set of rules or protocols that define their size and format. This is called as packet switching. So there is client, one client, and on the other side there is server. It follows the different paths between the computers. It transfers the data using packets in packet switch. Next is two of the mid-band technology, that is asymmetrical digital subscriber line, that is ADSL, and integrated services digital network, that is ISDN, uses wires to connect users to the internet through a telephone system. Another competing technology being the internet to home PCs using coaxial cables of cable television. Network routers. Okay. Next, we will see network router. Network designers use routers to transfer or route data between networks that use different network technology. Since the internet is comprised of various networks that use many different network technologies, router an integral part of the internet. Okay. Router is the integral part of the internet. A router has an address on the network. Using the addressing capability of routers, the nodes on a network can send packets designed for another network to a router. The router, in turn, will transfer the packet to the other network. This is network routers. Next, we will see connectionless versus connection-oriented protocols. These two protocols are very important. That one is connectionless and one is connection-oriented. So we will see what is connectionless protocol. It is client connects to the server. When clients make a request, get a response, and then disconnect. First, client is connected to the server. Its client make a request, get a response, and then disconnect. This is connectionless protocol. In connection-oriented protocol, client connects to the server, make a request, get response, and then maintain this connection to the service future request. Okay, this will maintain the connection for the future request to the server. Okay, this is connection oriented protocol. Example, what is the example for connection oriented protocol? That is FTP protocol. Okay, file transfer protocol. When you connect to an FTP server, the connection remains open after you download a file. Okay, make a request to download file, you get the downloaded file in response. In contrast, HTTP is connectionless protocol. FTP is connection oriented protocol, HTTPS, connectionless protocol. When client connects to the servers are only limited to active connections and can generally do thousands of transactions with low system overhead in connectionless protocol. Next, internet service provider, that is ISP. When a user issues a request on the internet from a computer, the request traverses or visits an ISP network, moves over one or more of the backbones and across another ISP network to the computer containing the information of interest. Okay, this is internet service provider. Commercialization of the internet has taken place in two spheres, users and ISP. At first, company, they access the internet through the existing non-profit mid-level networks where offered lower level of membership than the academic members. So what is ISP? ISP is in India, okay? Internet access in sense came into 1990. This ISP is when a user issues a request to the internet on the internet from a computer, the request traverses or visits an ISP network, moves over one or more of the backbones and across another ISP network to the computer containing the information of the interest. This is called as internet service provider. Next, we will see broadband technology. What is broadband technology? Broadband technology refers to the transmission medium or the physical connection with which users can access the internet at speed faster than the ones currently prevalent. Broadband access can be through any medium, that is copper, fiber, or wireless. This is broadband technology. Next, we will see there are different types of broadband networks. Digital subscriber line, okay? Digital subscriber line stands as DSL. What is DSL? It is the could deliver high bandwidth internet access over existing phone wiring. This is called a digital subscriber line. Next is asynchronous transfer mode, that is ATM. ATM emerged in the early in 1990s as telecommunication grew and technology that was being pushed to the enterprise land. ATM is layer 2 technology that established connection-oriented virtual circuit across the network, can either be manually configured using permanent virtual circuit or set up or tear down dynamically as needed using switch virtual circuit. Okay, this is ATM, asynchronous transfer mode. Right, next we will see there are Ethernet. What is Ethernet? Ethernet has phenomenal success in enterprise LAN since it is inception in 1980. Today, we will over 90% of deployed networks are based on this solid and standardized technology. That is IEEE. Okay, this is the Ethernet which gives 10 Mbps speed. Then 8023U, that it gives the fast Ethernet which gives 100 Mbps speed. In last lecture, we have seen there are different business to business model, business to consumer model, then B2C, B2B, C2C. Okay, we have seen this different business to business transaction model. In this chapter, this is limited to this World Wide Web and different e-commerce model like B2C, B2B and different networks and internet. In next lecture, we will start with next topic. Today we will stop with this lecture. In next lecture, we will start with the e-marketing. Okay. Thank you, everyone.